Well, this weekend, the Cape Palace Museum is looking to the future while remembering its rich past. Mm-hmm. The mansion part of the museum will have a grand reopening tomorrow.
Local 24 News reporter Chase Arnold got a behind-the-scenes look of what you can expect before the mansion officially reopens.
After years of renovation, the Pink Palace Museum is finally set to reopen its mansion to the public, giving visitors the chance to relive the amazing history of this unique building.
We wanted to tell one cohesive story, and we decided to do that by letting this mansion tell its own story through the people who've used it, so through the people who built it and how its uses have changed over time.
That starts with Clarence Saunders, the man who built the mansion and the founder of Piggly Wiggly. You can check out models of the country store and Piggly Wiggly, as well as countless artifacts that the museum was previously unable to show. Viewers will also get greater access to the museum.
People are going to be able to go up to the second floor, which people haven't been able to do since the 1970s. So people are going to get to walk up the grand staircase in the lobby, go see the Calicut murals from basically eye level.
You can also check out the new home of what is sure to be a fan favorite, the Clyde Park Circus, which received a lot of TLC over the past few years.
Fixing the mechanics on the bottom of the circus so that it can run on a limited schedule, and then conserving the top and cleaning everything in the circus. So thanks to that, the circus looks better than it's ever looked.
With the mansion now back open and running, museum officials are hoping that more people come back to visit the museum in the days and months to come. Reporting at the Pink Palace, Chase Arnold, Local 24 News.